Okay, electrostatics 20, electric potential 3, I think, if I remember it correctly. Okay, did we do potential of a point charge? I don't remember. Can you just remind?
We did till point charge.
Did we prove it as KQ by R?
Yes.
Sure.
Yes, sir. Vr is equal to KQ by R.
That we proved in the previous class.
That we ended.
Right. So now if I have a plus Q here at a distance R from it, the potential Vr you can write if you want, K into plus Q by R. This is a formula. The physical meaning of this is what? This is the amount of work done to bring plus 1 coulomb charge from infinity to the point here by the axial force against electrostatic repulsion. Do you follow? This is the formula. The formula's meaning is what? This is the work done. This is the work done to bring plus 1 coulomb charge. Why am I saying plus 1 coulomb? You know, the definition we know. I'll come back to that. Plus 1 coulomb from infinity to R. By whom? By the external force. Against gravity. Sorry, against electric force. Against electric force here means say that when we apply a force equal to electric force, the speed will be constant. But if you apply more than that, the speed will change. In that case, the work done by us against the electric force becomes potential energy, the remaining becomes kinetic energy. Okay, this is one important idea. Therefore, when I said constant speed, all the work done by the external agent against the electric force becomes potential energy only. All right. And similarly, if I have a minus Q here at a distance R from it, potential is K into minus Q by R. All right.
Yes.
And why 1 coulomb we put, you know, we defined it as V at R equals W infinity to R by
Q
naught. That means if you do a work of W infinity to R for Q naught for 1 coulomb, how much is W infinity to R by Q naught, which we call as potential. Okay. So this formula and as well the physical meaning of it should be very, very clearly kept in the mind. Okay. And we also mentioned, I think, whenever I have a system of charges, we should write the potential energy of every pair of charge to write the potential energy of the system. Did I tell you that?
Yes, sir.
Now, we can take an example for that. Like I have a system of charges like this. Plus Q. Plus Q, plus Q, plus Q. This side of the square is A. The charges are at the vertices. So potential energy, electrostatic potential energy of the system will be how much? Come on. I told you, what should we do?
Consider potential energy for every
pair of charge and add. So this is common, so I'll take it common outside. So QQ by A, QQ by A, QQ by A, QQ by A. How many are there? Four. Potential energy is what? Potential into charge brought.
Yes, sir.
And again for the diagonal.
That is 2 times?
Q by A.
Q by root 2A.
Yes, sir. The distance will be A root 2A.
This potential energy of the system is nothing but, you know, I'll tell you. Say first we place plus Q. No work, children. Huh? Because there's no charge in the vicinity of this charge, so no work is done. But I'll bring one more charge and bring, put another plus Q from infinity to here. So we can say that potential energy is 1 by 4 pi epsilon Q into Q by A, because it's like this. Potential of this charge is 1 by 4 pi epsilon Q by A into Q. So here when we wrote all these potential energies, you can look at it in a different way. I have got plus Q here, no work. But I got plus Q here, one more plus Q here. Potential of this is Q by A into Q is the potential energy. Do you follow?
Yes, sir.
So that's how potential and potential energy have to be connected. So write this answer, we'll continue after this. Potential is for 1 coulomb, potential energy is for Q coulombs. Isn't it so? Just now, this definition only you take. W infinity to R will be what? Potential at R into Q. So this is potential into the charge brought. So once this is brought, one more thing you bring. You work against this, you work against this. Potential of this here is KQ by A. Into work done is KQ by A into this Q. Potential of this at this point is KQ by root 2A. KQ by root 2A into this plus Q. Work done against this. Now when you bring the fourth one, potential of this into A, potential of this into Q, potential of this into Q, potential of this into Q. That's what we wrote. So both mathematically, physically, you got connection between, you got the meaning of potential and potential energy, and also the connection between the two. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Right.
Complete.
And potential and electric field strength are the properties, the field. Okay? Force and potential energy are the values which will be decided according to the test charge. This statement I've been making many times after showing problems. Right. Then superposition of potentials. Superposition of potentials. Okay. Like V equals V1 plus V2 plus V3 like this. What does it mean? It is simply the scalar sum of potentials due to individual charges. Compare it with superposition of forces and fields. You write superposition of forces as F equals like this, you write. Superposition of fields you write as E equals like this. But here no vector signs anywhere. Do you follow? This is the potential due to all charges. The scalar sum of the potential due to individual charges. Do you follow that? To understand it, immediately we can go for an example. This example only you take, the one we did for electric field strength. A plus Q minus Q minus Q. So potential at the center of the square we wanted. Tell me, potential will be potential due to all charges V1 plus V2 plus V3 plus V4. Potential due to this plus Q will be how much? K into plus Q by A by root 2.
root 2. Yes, sir.
This is it. This is A by root. I've told you many times. Potential, this is K into plus Q by
A by root.
A by root 2. Potential that will be plus K into
minus
Q by
A by root 2.
Similarly, plus into K into minus Q by A by root. Potential is here 0. But do you remember E was not 0? E was 4 root 2 K Q by A square. Left, refer back.
Yes, sir. Because the direction is there.
So I don't want to mix it up with this, but just the old question you see, you will know. E of this is this way, E of this is this way, E of this is this way, E of this is that way. We added all the E's vectorially, right?
Yes, sir.
Refer back to that example immediately. That means here E is not 0. Huh? Do you follow? But potential is 0. Do you remember the procedure of calculating E or not? Otherwise, I told you, just refer back. Principle of superposition of electric fields, since you'll be there. Exactly the same question we did that time.
Yes. Done, sir.
Right. Another example. A like this. Plus Q, minus Q, plus Q, minus Q. So could you tell me what will happen to potential and field strength at center? E equals how much? V equals how much?
V will be 0.
Hmm?
Potential will be 0.
Potential will be 0. Because we do the exactly the same way we did. How about E?
E will also be 0.
E will also be 0. Plus Q's E is this way. Plus Q's E is this way, and they are equal in magnitude because Q is same, distance is same. KQ by R square. Field of this will be which way? This way. Potential of the field of that will be this way. Even they are equal and opposite. So this is a case where E is 0 and V is 0.
Yes.
Previous example, see, E is not 0, but V is 0. Hmm? Hello?
Yes.
So another example you can take. Same thing. Plus Q, plus Q, plus Q, plus Q. E equals how much? And V equals how much? Side length is A.
Sir, E is 0.
E is 0 as usual, isn't it? Why? I need not to tell you. Plus Q, C is this way. This plus Q is opposite. Like that, E will be 0.
Yes.
But V will be not 0. Huh? V will be potential of individual charges. KQ by A by root 2 4 times.
Yes.
Isn't it? Plus KQ by A by root 2 plus KQ by A by root 2 KQ by R plus KQ by A by root 2 like this. Isn't it? So that is equal to what? 4 times root 2 KQ by A. So this is a case E is 0 but V is not 0. This is a case V is 0, E is 0. The old case was what?
V is
0. E is not 0.
V is 0.
V is 0. So, is there anything left? E is not zero, V is not zero, case is left, right?
Yes.
Refer back.
Both.
Both not zero case, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
So that we can create. Can you create one similar question? E is there, V is there.
Sir, we'll have to take only one negative charge or one positive charge.
No, first, the square if I would like to take.
Yes, sir, for square only like three positive, one negative, or three negative, one positive.
So, plus Q, plus Q, plus Q, minus Q, she says. Huh?
Yes.
So, what will be E? E because of these two is zero, right? At the center.
Yes, sir. Minus Q, direction.
They will be opposite, in opposite directions. Equal but opposite. Here, it, because of this charge, it will be away. Because this charge, it is towards it.
They'll add up.
So they'll add up. How much is that? 2 times KQ by A by root 2 whole
A
square.
A by root 2, yes.
Isn't it so?
Yes.
Do you follow?
Yes, sir.
And potential also. V equals 3 times KQ by A by root 2 minus KQ by A by root. No directions, no vectors, nothing. Isn't it?
Yes.
So this became 2 KQ by A by root 2. So neither E is 0 nor V is 0. Remember, E and V are, I told you, one is vector quantity, the other is a scalar quantity. We can describe the space filled with charges with these two quantities, electric field strength and electric potential.
Sir,
If
3 are negative and 1 is positive, then also the same will happen.
3 are negative and 1 is positive.
Oh.
Only thing is, the numerical answers are same, but the direction of V will be different. Different means?
Yes.
Towards minus once again, but towards, what did you say? 3 minus 1 plus Q. Check it.
Yes.
Come on. Let us look at this. So 3 minus, minus Q, minus Q, minus Q, plus Q wanted, right? Yeah. So due to these two minus Qs, it is 0. Yeah. E. So due to this plus Q, it is like this. Due to this minus Q, it is like this. So the field has same value, but previously it was this way, it is this way now. Potential has any way, no direction. So now, but this sign will be different. 3 into K into minus Q by A by root 2 plus K A by root 2. So it is totally minus 2 KQ by A by root 2. And compare this and that. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Electric field, electric potential. These are some ideas, concepts. Electric field is a concept, if you want to say. Tell me. So anytime, remember, whenever you're finding out electric field strength or electric potential at a point, there's nothing like a charge placed there. Do you follow? Hello?
Yes, sir, because it will be due to
the field, and you think of placing a charge, you think of bringing a charge. It is the property of the space here. Property of the space in terms of electric field. Do you follow? Q is there means there will be field strength of this here. That is allegedly force on a plus one coulomb charge. Do you follow?
Yes.
Whenever I talk, meaning people don't respond. Some kind of algebra keeps happening. All right, I'll continue. Yes, another question here. Plus Q, plus Q, plus Q. So electric field strength and electric potential at the center E equals how much? V equals how much? At O. Tell me. E will be zero.
Yes, 120 degrees.
I already have talked about it. I don't want to talk it about again. V will be simply V1 plus V2 plus V3, scalar sum. K Q by the side length is A. This will be how much I told you? A by
root 3.
So K Q by A by root 3. So root 3 goes up. Now how many are there like that? 3.
3 root 3.
3 root 3 K Q by A. That's all. Similarly, now plus Q. Plus Q, minus 2Q. This also was given previously, but let me see. E and V at O. This is O. Come on. Tell me,
V is zero.
V is how much?
Zero.
V is
zero.
Zero. He already have told you how to find. How will you say V is zero? V equals V1 plus V2 plus V3. Three charges are there. V1 because of this K into plus Q by A by root 3. Due to this, K into plus Q by A by root 3. Due to that, K into minus 2Q by A by root 3. Isn't it so?
Yes, sir.
And electric field we found out due to plus Q, it is like this. These are vectors, so you have to show vectors there. This is E because of this. This is E because of this. Angle between which is 120. So if this is E, if this is E in magnitude, it will be E like this. But E1 because of that will be this way. So the net E equals E plus E1. E is what? KQ by A by root 3 whole square. even is what k into, don't write minus sign here because we are already showing that we are adding it here. K to q by a by root 3 whole square. Finally, we showed that it is what? 9 k q by a square. Look back. This was done previously. It is shown again, once again, here. Tell me. So, a similar question which was done for E, I'll bring back again for V. I've got x equals 0 here, at x equals 1, at x equals 2, at x equals 4, at x equals what? 8. We've got plus q, plus q, plus q, plus q, up to infinity. So V at x equals 0, how much? Tell me. So what should I write?
V equals KQ, yeah.
Yeah. KQ by 1 plus KQ by 2
plus KQ by 4
plus
K.
Isn't it so? Up to infinity.
Yes.
So KQ, if I take common, what will I get?
1 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 4 1 by 8.
So infinite GP. KQ into A by 1 minus R. Isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
So 2KQ. All right?
Yes.
We have done the electric field sense for this, if you remember.
Yes, sir.
Okay, now we'll make every alternate charge a negative one. Find the potential. This is minus, this is minus, like that. Plus q minus q plus q minus q up to infinity. So at x equals 0, potential.
2kq by 3.
Just a minute. This is minus, minus. So nothing would change. Look at this. Kq into, only the sign changes. 1 minus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 4 minus. So kq into a, 1 by 1 minus r. R is common ratio, 1 by 4 by 1 minus by 1 by 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2. 1 by 8 minus 1 by 4, like that. Minus half, isn't it? So minus half? Minus half.
Minus of minus.
Isn't it so? So what do I get? 2?
Kq by 3.
3. Okay?
Yes, sir.
So, apart from doing these questions, very simple questions, one important idea would be this. We want to make you feel comfortable with the idea called E and V. E is vector, V is scalar. V tells you about the work, E tells you about the force. This kind of what you call conceptualization is important. Okay.
Yes.
So can I continue?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. So we are dealing with electric potential, right? Electric potential due to continuous charge distributions. Potential due to continuous what? Charge distributions. Before that, okay, let us do this. After that, I'll come back anyway. Look, can you tell me what is the first kind of charge distribution I would like to take? You can have, once again, a linear charge you can have in general. You can have surface charge and you can have volume charge. These are the generalizations, right? So what do you mean by linear charge? Charge lined up in one dimension like this. So linear charge density was lambda, that was dq by dl. Surface charge density is, tell me, dq by
dA.
dA. Volume charge density is
dq by dv.
dv. Now we would like to find out the potential of various charge configurations. The first one could be a simple one. Potential due to a ring of charge. Potential due to a ring of charge. I have a ring of charge like this. You may say it has got a charge Q spread over it uniformly with a charge density Q, charge density lambda, charge Q, radius R. At a distance X from it, how much is the potential? Tell me now. There are two ways of doing it. The basic way is this, children. Listen to me. Here, V2 minus V1 equals, the way we defined it was what? Work done.
Infinity to R.
No, V2 minus V1.
Yes, sir. 1 to 2.
1 to 2 by Q0 by external force. R V2 minus V1 equals minus
1 to 2.
1 to 2 by Q0
by the electric
force. Electric field or electric force. But what is this minus 1 to 2? That is F electric dot dr, isn't it? By Q0. But what is F electric by Q0? E.
E.
So this is the definition we are going to use basically. This is the integral form of relation between E and V, children. Do you understand? Yes. This integral form of relation between potential difference and E. All right. Hello.
Yes. Yes.
Yes, sir.
So now tell me, E for a ring, we already calculated, if you remember. How much is that? K Q X by
under X square plus R square to the power 3 by 2.
X square plus R square to the power
3 by 2.
3 by 2. And dx will be away anyway. This is always an x equals 0. So dx is also like this. We can write a dx into I cap. Okay. So V2 minus V1 equals V infinity minus v at r, v at x is equal to minus x to infinity. This is e bar equals I cap, right?
Yes, sir.
So e dot dx will be what? KQx
pi
x square plus r square to the power
3/2 dx.
Right?
Yes, sir. Yes.
So look at this, v infinity is 0. 0 minus vx, this minus minus goes, right? So
yes,
vx equals simply integral x to infinity, this integration. So I can take that kq, all that outside first, right? Kq, I can take out, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
X to infinity, yeah. Infinity. What do I have? X dx by? Can I write 2x dx there? By 2 here I'll put.
Yes, sir.
X square plus r square to the power?
3/2.
So what do I do now?
X square plus r square, we take it to be something.
So that will be 2x dx will be what? If I take
dt, sir.
X square plus r square equals t. If I take 2x dx equals
dt by t to the power 3/2.
So dt t to the power 3/2. And the units will be what, children? X, when I put x here,
r square to infinity.
0 to x, right? Our integration was x to infinity, yeah?
Yes.
So if I put x there.
Sir, x to infinity, we should write it as r to infinity.
X to infinity as what?
Lower limit is x squared plus r squared.
You have taken x squared plus r squared equals t. So in terms of t, I should write the what you call, if it is x
plus r squared.
Hello. X to infinity. What should I put the limits of t here as?
X squared plus r squared.
Sir, x square plus r square.
Here, x square plus r square I should put.
Yes.
Tell me, if this x is here, when I take x square plus r square is t, what will be that x square plus r square? Later, infinity.
Yes, sir.
So what do I get? T to the power minus 3/2 plus 1 by minus 3/2 plus 1, isn't it? Hello? How many times should I do this? Hello? Enadayana?
Sir, kq by x into under root x square plus r square.
So what do I get? Kq by 2 into
minus
2 minus 2
by 1 root.
Minus
2 by root t, sir.
3 minus 3/2 plus, yes, half. Minus half, right? 2 goes up.
Yes, minus,
minus 2 by under root.
Under root? T. So 2 goes.
Yes.
Right? So minus kq 1 by, tell me. infinity 0 minus 1 by
under root x square plus r square.
What do I get? Minus minus going
k cube by under root x square plus r square.
Tell me. I've done all over again deliberately. But we could also use the formula of potential for a point charge. Can I go to the next page?
Yes. Yes, sir.
Don't know how many are writing only. So now, otherwise, we can do which way? Otherwise, look, we can use the formula of potential for a point charge. We had V equals K Q by R for a point charge, right? Isn't it? Hello?
Yes.
This we got by taking potential zero, potential to be zero at infinity only, right? So when I have my ring of charge like this, at a distance x, if I wanted the potential, since this is a uniformly charged ring, for example, can I not find the potential of a single charge, some small elementary charge like this dq? If this is r here, so potential due to dq will be how much? Directly potential I am writing, potential due to dq, not the potential difference between one point as a point. Potential already is defined here. That is, yes. dv, I can say. It's not v2 minus v1. The absolute potential of dq at this point. dv equals k dq by r. Isn't it?
Yes.
R is constant for all the elements. Integral dq from 0 to q. So kq by r simply. What is r?
From Pythagoras theorem, under root r square plus x square.
Simple way. So we use the potential formula of a point charge. Do you follow?
Yes, sir.
And at x equals 0, potential is not 0. Kq by root r square is r. And k is, don't forget, 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 all the time.
Yes.
Okay.
Done, sir.
So you may ask, why this potential? What is the use of this formula? And you should be able to remember, we have done similar things in gravitation also, haven't we?
Yes.
So one problem I can put. There's a charge ring like this. Charge Q. This ring is fixed. Okay. Now I release a minus Q from here with zero initial velocity. This is a plus Q charge. So E of this will be this way. Force on this will be this way, right?
Yes.
See, it is easy to say plus Q attracts minus because that is so much in our minds. Like why plus and minus attract, we never thought. Somebody told in the beginning itself, like charges ripple, unlike charges attract. that's okay. I have no problem. Plus Q will attract minus Q anyway, but it won't attract that way. Remember, this is all charge spread. E of this we found out to be this way. So E is a force on a unit positive charge, but here I placed minus, so force will be applied this way, right? Huh?
Yes.
So it will go like this, accelerate, accelerate, velocity becomes maximum and then goes there and comes back like this, isn't it?
Yes.
For small x's, we can show that is simple harmonic motion, for example.
Yes.
So if this is x, for x, show that motion is for small x. Show that motion is SHM. And find time period. Okay. That's one thing. Second is find the velocity at O, the center of the ring. How do we do that? The first part is with E. Second part is with V. Right?
Yes.
So E on the axis is how much? E will be K Qx by x squared plus R squared to the power 3 by 2. So the force on, you can say the mass of this particle is given, M. So force on that will be M into this one, M into E, right? It was Q into E, sorry. That is K Q Qx by x squared plus R squared to the power 3 by 2. That will be equal to mass into acceleration. So for small x's, I can ignore what is x squared. So MA equals K Q X by R cube. All right. So A equals K Q Q by M R cube into X. So A is proportional to X. So motion is simple harmonic motion. Anytime A is proportional to X, simple harmonic motion. In the place of omega square, I have K Q Q by M R cube. So time period is, you can write 2 pi by time period whole square equals K Q by M R cube. So time period you write from here. And if you want the potential velocity at A, use the potential energy, mechanical energy conservation. U1 plus K1 here is equal to U2 plus K2 here. Isn't it?
Yes.
So second part, U1 plus K1 equals U2 plus K2, let us use, not force idea. With force also, I can get velocity by going for integration. But otherwise, this is easier way. U1, potential energy of minus Q, when it is this point is potential of the ring into charge. Potential of the ring at that point is how much? Tell me. K plus Q by root of
x square plus R square.
This is R radius. This is the potential. Potential energy will be into Q. Minus Q, that is. Plus K1 is 0. U2 will be what? Potential at this point will be KQ by R at this point. X is 0. Into minus Q plus half M V square in the center. This K1 is 0 here. Hello?
Yes, sir.
So we'll get V from here. So in the same question, electric field strength idea is used and electric potential idea is used. Come on. They're similar to what we have done in gravitation, children.
Yes, sir.
So space was not there, so I did not complete. Please do that completion. If you want that to be a little smaller, you can put x equals some 2r if you want it. But this is, this definition is nothing to do with x less than r. I'm sorry. Small x is not required for this. Do you follow? Only for showing simple harmonic motion that was required.
Yes, sir.
If you want to make the calculation simpler here, calculate the velocity for x equals, say, r again, if you want. Hello?
Yes.
It's visible there. If I put x equals r, it becomes root 2r, right?
Yes, root 2 will be there.
So,
1 minus 1.
Aq by r can be taken out. Isn't it? It goes that side. This becomes plus. So what do I get? K Q by R is taken out.
Yes, into what 1 minus
1 minus
1 by root 2.
1 by root 2 is equal
into,
to
is equal to half mv square.
Half mv square.
Yes, 2
so
and
this
m
goes there. M go, I mean 2 goes up, m comes down, v square under root, all that will give you v.
Yes, got it.
Otherwise, if you want to put it in x terms, you can leave it. So potential is very important to apply that in the mechanical energy conservation. So if I want the potential of this here, I should know the potential of, if I want to know the potential energy of this here, this one. Hello?
Yes.
If I want to know the potential energy of this Q here, electrostatic potential energy, I should know the potential of this here, which is given by whatever formula. Isn't it KQ by this one? Into the charge, if you put, you have the U here. That U is also equal to the work done by somebody else in bringing that Q from infinity to this point against electrostatic force. Do you follow? So there is a scheme of things to understand here, not blind doing. Hello?
Yes.
So whether it is gravitational or electrostatic or spring potential energy, the main ideas are same, only the formulas are different. Hello?
Yes.
All right. A lot more is there. I don't want to start a new thing now. We'll close it for now. And we'll come back. Yes, tell me.
Sir, will you please show the previous one?
This is the formula of potential we derived by using potential of a point charge, Aryan.
Yes.
Next, there are derivations, but they take time, so I'm just not starting it now. Can I stop it?
Thank you.
Thanks. Mm-hmm.